Hi, everyone. My name is Michael, and with me is Tiffany. And we're both from the search quality team here at Google. And we're handling the webmaster question today. And this one comes from Matt Cutts in the Bay Area. And Matt wants to know, can you tell us about the reconsideration process from Google's perspective? And has there been anything that's changed in the process recently?
So to start with, I'm a webmaster. How do I know if I should file a reconsideration request?
Sure. There are a few indications as to when it might be a good time to file a reconsideration request. First of all, if you know that you have violated one of Google's webmaster guidelines, that would be an excellent time to first clean up your site. So make sure that you're in compliance with the webmaster guidelines, and then let us know that you've made changes. You know, I've removed the hidden text or something like that, and then file for reconsideration. We've also been working on notifying people when we notice that there's been an issue with their site. So maybe you were hacked and we've detected it, and a hacker has put spam on your site. We'll often send you a message within, again, Webmaster Tools, letting you know that there's an issue with your site. Again, clean it up and file for reconsideration. And sometimes you might see that you know, your site isn't showing up in search results, or you've seen a loss of search traffic. Sometimes that can be a spam issue, and so that's also another good time to go ahead and file for reconsideration. Though before you do that, I would recommend checking out a help article that we have called Site Not Doing Well in Search, and we can leave a link to that, which explains some other reasons why your site might not be doing well beyond having a spam issue. So that's how you know it might be a good time to file for reconsideration. So Tiffany, maybe you can talk about when I do file a reconsideration request as a webmaster, what makes a really good request? What should I write?
Good question. So what we're really looking for in your reconsideration request is you say what spam issue you had and what steps you took to fix the problem. So you're not helping anyone if you don't admit what the problem was, because we already know there's no sense hiding it. So tell us what the specific violation was. Maybe you had some bad SEO advice from someone. Whatever the issue was, point out the issue and point out exactly what steps you took to fix it. So an example, if you give a reconsideration request like, my site adheres to the guidelines, that's not as useful as a request that says, I had some hidden text on the homepage, but now I've removed it. In that second example, you're saying what the problem was, and you're saying what you did to fix it. So those are the type of requests that make it really easy for us to handle, because it's very straightforward for us. So Michael, from a Google perspective, what happens after I submit my request?
Yeah, sure. So in cases where there was a manual spam action on that site, we'll actually have a human from the web spam team go ahead and look at that request. And a little bit about, you know, what they see when they're processing this reconsideration request is they can see what that manual spam action was that was placed on the site in the past. They can see what you wrote in Webmaster Tools when you were filing your reconsideration request. And they also, of course, can check out the site. They can load it as Googlebot. They have you know, a few other tools that we use to evaluate the quality of websites. And what they're looking for is simply, is this site still violating the guidelines, or is this site now clean and it's you know, spam free? And so in the case that the webmaster hasn't cleaned things up yet, that request, of course, would be denied. But if the webmaster had, you know, they received a notification, you know, maybe they, you know, someone else had done something to their site, either they were hacked or bad SEO or something like that, cleaned it up, they were, you know, wrote exactly what it was in the reconsideration request, then the reviewer would notice that. And they actually have the ability right there to go ahead and revoke that manual action. And so that's pretty much how a reconsideration request would be processed on our end. So once we're done with it, you know, we've, you know, say we've revoked the manual action on that site, what would the webmaster look forward to happening next?
Yeah. So we know that this is a stressful time for webmasters. You've submitted this request, and then you're just kind of waiting to hear back. And in the past, we didn't do very much in terms of communication back to you. But we've listened. We've heard a lot of webmasters say, we want more communication about what happened to my request. We've heard this, and we're looking for a lot of ways to improve the process. So a long time ago, we sent nothing back after your request was processed. And then a little while ago, we started sending messages of your request was processed, but no specifics about what the outcome was. Recently, in some cases, we're able to give now messages that say specifically what the outcome was. So, for example, if you had a manual spam action that we were able to revoke, in a lot of cases, we're able to tell you. Or if you are still in violation of our guidelines and you need to take a harder look and figure out maybe it's hacked and you know it's hacked, but you couldn't find and remove all of the bad content, we'll let you know. In the majority of the time, we actually send a message that says you weren't affected by any spam action at all. So in those cases, you can take a look at our Help Center articles, figure out maybe you have some access issues, maybe you're blocking us in your robots.txt. A good place to go is look in the forum and ask your question there. There's a lot of really helpful people, a lot of external users, and Googlers also read the forums. Even if they don't post, they might read and ask questions to the internal teams that actually handle the reconsideration request. So you might be able to get help that way.
Yep. So, I hope that gives you some good insights into how reconsiderations work at Google.